And now, a brief word to everyone who enjoys this program.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Hello is the shampoo that glorifies your hair. So, hello, everybody. Hello. For softer, lively curls and brighter, sparkling hair. So, hello, everybody. Hello. Hello, shampoo.
You okay with music? It don't bother you? I like a good tune. Makes days spin along somehow. In the movies, I like movies. But who'd have guessed that there was commies in Hollywood? How do you like that? You pay him a dime for a couple of movies, and Joe McCarthy's caught about feeding us commie propaganda. We was paying to watch it. Quit dancing about, will you? I'm good, but you keep bobbing, you'll get cut. Consider my reputation. I never as much as nick anyone. You gotta try and think about something else. That's the trick of it. Did you see the game on TV last night? Or was it the night before? Much more of this. I'm gonna start getting jittery. Think of somewhere you've been. Somewhere real nice. Seashore, how about that? Boardwalk, sand. I grew up in a town like that. And the girls. Oh my, the beautiful girls. Yeah, maybe not. Hey, look, this is a one-time deal. I can tell you something that'll make your hair stand on end. Make my job easier. But it's a secret, a real secret. You gotta swear to me here and now that you'll never breathe a word of this to no one, never. You got that? Now you gotta swear. It's real important that you ain't never gonna tell no one. Right. I used to run a little business. Barbara. Main Street store. Nothing fancy, but it was the only game in town. Was never gonna make me rich, but then I weren't gonna die of starvation either. I was getting ready to shut up one evening when two guys come in. Now, they don't want haircuts because they've already got real beauts. They say they're from the military base. It's a little way out of town. Ordinarily, wouldn't see any of their custom, because they got their own barber. Now, these two guys breeze in, and they have a kind of like authority. They are used to having people do what they say. And they say They want me to do some work on the base. You got your own guy, tell him. Yeah, they say, but he's off sick or something. This is an emergency. Now, I'd never heard of a barber in emergency before, but I could tell these guys weren't jokers. I was going to get paid for my time as well as for the work, and it was closing up anyway, so I figured, why not? I collected up some scissors, razors, and soap, walked off to their car, and off we went. After we parked up, these two guys escort me, real close, to a small hospital. But it's got big toys and a climbing frame. It's a research center, they tell me. And I get shown a room with three tables with what looks like kids lying on them under white sheets. Now, I'm already getting not happy. And then they face me with what I'm thinking is some kind of pediatric mortuary. And I'm starting to think, here I am, sliding deeper and deeper into something hellish. One of the guys, he can see I'm getting skittish. He pulls back one of the sheets and says, see, there's nothing to worry about. I look, and it's a goddamn monkey. And it ain't dead, it's breathing. Now, this plane flies higher than any plane before. Stratosphere, they said. Takes photos of foreign parts without anyone who lives there knowing about it. Now, the guys who fly these things have to wear special high-altitude pressure suits. And they got this new one that's being tested. They don't want to test on a real pilot because, well, they cost a lot to train. So what are they going to do? Build a capsule, string it up to a balloon, and send up the goddamn monkeys. Then at the last minute, some expert tells them the tests will be worthless because monkeys don't sweat like men because they're covered in hair. So what are they going to do now? Shave the goddamn monkeys, that's what. They wheel in the barber. They keep on the base. He's lathering up this ape who's eating the soap as fast as he can put it on. Ape starts vomiting. Barber gets so badly bitten, he's hospitalized. Okay. So now they get the idea of it. They feed the monkeys knockout drops and fetch me in. So like I said, I'm getting paid. It's legit work. So I just get on with it. I shave these critters from head to toe. So, now the job's all done. They bring in proper tail of little high-altitude suits, dress them up, load them into a pressurized capsule, and shoot them up into the sky. Of course, the whole stupid contraption crashed somewhere in the desert. Killed two of the monkeys outright. Government men did get to it. Not before it was found, reported to a deadhead sheriff and his sidekicks from some Dust Bowl town. Of course, as far as they were concerned, these gray-skinned little critters with big liquid eyes and high-altitude suits couldn't be nothing but spacemen. Little critters from Mars or somewhere. Now, Uncle Sam is hardly going to admit having treated the poor dumb critter so badly. So the sheriff and his men have never told the truth. They're still out there now blathering about alien something or others. But everyone else, including me, now you, is solemnly sworn to secrecy. Remember, sworn to secrecy. You're lucky it's just me telling you this. Government damn near made me sign in blood. Not a scratch. Not a nick.
Sure hope you didn't tell no one.